What up, guys? Vico Khan here. Super excited to show you a video about conversation AI and how we sell it as AI phone number and the actual script that I have right now with me. We're going to show you the script and we'll try my best to explain you the workflow and how to set it up and everything. But most importantly, how we can pitch that to our real estate agent. Let's just start with the script first, right? So this is a message with me and my own page that have conversation AI installed. And it start off with, this is Vico from Vicolize Online Consultant. Did you inquire about a property update on Facebook? So this is assuming that the lead coming from Facebook, right? And I replied, yes, I guess. Very skeptical. How soon do you want to sell or move out? And I replied, none of your business. Now, this is the first objection that I saw at the bot. I say, understood, haha, got it. Do you have any other question for me? I said, how much do you charge? Get straight to the point. Our fee depend on services needed. How soon do you want to sell or move out? Now this is the bot second attempt to actually ask me the qualify question, right? And you know, I just replied, fine, 3 months or more. Shoot, what do you have to offer? I'm talking with a few more real estate agent right now. So, and it replied, I tailor service as per your need. How about I share some insight with you? Have you done any major renovation to your property? And now this is the second qualified question that the bot asked me. I set it to ask people two qualification questions before sending the booking link, right? And I replied, 50K on recent bathroom renovation. Now I'm broke. I wouldn't be able to pay anything upfront. What's the price? Got it. We can discuss commission after your property sell. How about we book a meeting to discuss this further? This is our booking link and schedule link, and then drop the link, right? So you can see here the bot only give the booking link after I answer the qualification question, which is two of them, right? How soon do you want to move out and how much have you spent on renovating your property, right? And that is the key important when it comes to selling a property for our agent at least, right? And we work in Australia, right? This is for Australia. So again, if you work in America or Canada, we're going to tell you how to modify that very easily. But we want to get straight to how are we pitching this. Now I'll show you how to set it up, right? So our core offer is actually giving real estate agent this two core pillar, which is database AI integration, AI phone number, and two-click proven real estate template, right? But this video is gonna focus on the AI phone number, which is the conversation AI. We're not just really selling the conversation AI, right? We're selling it as a package to help real estate agents solve their problem, which is lead generation and lead nurture, right? Getting them more lead and getting them more book appointment, right? So this conversation AI is one small puzzle into like a bigger pain point for real estate agents. And it's even micro niche down with this AI phone number. So when we come into pitching this AI phone number, we're saying, so after we get your lead working with our list, we want to get you set up with our AI phone number for your outbound lead, right? So our AI phone number system does a couple of things. The first is what we call a missed call text back. So with all this extra volume that we see in your business, right, that we see as business owner, you couldn't keep up, right? So for every lead that call for 30 seconds long and without being picked up, our AI phone number will text them a convenient time from your calendar via SMS. So this pretty much is a missed call text back, right? I'll just show you guys how to set up everything with the AI phone number system that we're selling. Right, so we just go to setting here, and I believe it's in business profile, and you just have to have this check on. It's never been so easy, but what we did is that we actually including this text, you know, please book a call here, and actually call with 2L, and I just literally just go in here, and we go to user calendar link, right? User calendar link. So that's all we did for our real estate agents. So it's like, I can't tell you how much GoHighLevel make this so easy for us. Like back then it used to be like a hustle. You got to make workflow for it. And the second thing involve AI phone number is that our number is actually integrate with our trained AI system. And it will be able to respond to any question about your business and push them to book a call with you directly on a calendar, right? So, and I would just state, like, if I'm on a call with real estate agent, I'll just state, like, this is for Facebook lead, right? So for any lead that didn't book or any lead that come from Facebook, our AI will be responding to question that be training specifically on for your business. I'll tell you guys how to set that up again, training the AI for your client, right? And the best thing is that our AI phone number actually work offline and it will be able to integrate directly with billboard, droplet, and any other form of offline marketing with analytic include, right? So now this is really specific for real estate agent in Australia or even in America, right? So this is what offline marketing look like. Most real estate agent advertising like really recklessly on the bus. Like this is really expensive on billboard, on bus, on droplet. And they just put their face and they just put like phone number here, like Sandra here, just put her phone number. Now this is quite a waste, right? We can actually monitor that. Like for example, like if you're on a sales call with real estate agent, like I'll just pull this up, this picture. I'd say, for example, Sandra here would have no idea how many people call her from this billboard ad. She have no idea, right? Right, because her phone doesn't track that. With our system, we can actually track that, right? And we're actually going to give you analytic on top of it. I'm going to show you guys how to do that. But what they need to do is that they just need to have a keyword on their billboard. So for example, instead of putting the phone number reckless like this, we just put like text billboard. If they text billboard, we can set them into a workflow, right? We'll show you guys how to do that. So quickly here, guys, to set up offline marketing campaign, and this is like what happening on the bus or newspaper or whatnot. You want to go to this one and you want to really tell your client to put a keyword on their offline advertisement, right? So if they do it on a bus or on a billboard like this, they have to put a keyword, like, you know, any keyword would do, like white, red, or even property or home, right? And what you can do is that you can create a custom, you can see here, this trigger for this campaign is always customer reply. You can see you're gonna put here customer reply in channel SMS, right? Because, and then obviously they have to put the AI phone number on here, not their personal phone number, right? And then they would have to put like half contained phrase property. Whatever phrase that you put on a billboard, you wanna do that, right? So if you put like, let's say white, right? And we're going to go ahead and save it. Okay. In this one, Sandra would have put like text white 204, whatever, right? Her phone number is text white 204 thing. And when people see a billboard, people text white to that number, then the bot will kick in. And that's how you set offline marketing campaign workflow for this AI conversation bot. All right, guys, it's time to explain the workflow. So we're going to start off with trigger, and we're just going to put here customer reply or form field or someone opting in. It doesn't really matter what trigger you have, but most importantly, what matters most is the trigger message, right? And this is going to be the only different thing in all of this. This is the only variable in all of this workflow. These workflow that you see here, you can see here DR3, DR1, which is stand for database reactivation 3, database reactivation 1 and offline marketing, all of this stuff, they're all the same. The workflow is exactly the same. The only difference is the first SMS that go out, right? So this SMS like tell you how to change that, how to really modify that in the custom value section. But that's the only thing that is different between all of this workflow. So how it works is that it's going to trigger with the first message and it's going to wait for a reply. And if people doesn't reply, if people don't reply, it go to this route, right? This condition, and people that reply will go to this route, right? So I'm going to try my best to explain it. If people reply, they will go to qualification question one, and the bot will try to ask them qualification question one, whatever that, you know, how much do you want to lose weight? Whatever that it is, you make it to be like that. And I'll tell you, because in this question, it's actually a custom value. So if you just change it, then like it's all fixed, right? And if people doesn't respond on your question, the bot will keep asking, just like what you saw on the first message in the beginning of this video, right? The actual conversation log. And what if they answer, it go to qualification question two. And if they don't like answer you, it will come back and ask them again. And if they answer, they go to booking bot again. And the booking bot will have the booking link right here, right? Hang on. The booking bot will be having the booking link. See, question, this is our booking link. And it's again, all of it is custom value and you just have to do a few things. This is just my attempt trying to explain it to you guys. So the next question that I will get is, how do you actually train this to match your industry, to match your need or your client need, right? So that's good. That's a good question. We just need to really change it to, like, we just change a few sentence in the prompt. For example, what I did, right? This is the qualification bot, right? Qualify bot. It's just saying you're a highly skilled appointment setter, a rockstar salesman for this company, and your name is this AI system, and this is about company, right? So pretty much in the prompt already, right? I leave the prompt, everything the same. I just add the last line, which is, you've been a real estate agent for 10 years in location city. That's all I did, right? Guys, all the script, all the prompt will be including in a snapshot. So what you need to do is just change number 5 to, you've been a plumber, you've been a chiropractor for 10 years in location city, right? Location city, it should be populated when the account is created. So it's not hard. So the next thing is the follow-up bot, right? I got a little creative with this, obviously, first of all, the objective is different, right? You have not received a response for your last message and your goal is to come up with unique response with a follow-up message, right? So this is like the original prompt, you would have get that. But what this is what I add, this is all right, what I add personally. I said, you know, mention that there will be a bonus or bonuses or some sort of surprise industry related after they book. So please confirm so we can send it over. Tell them that user first name should be like your client name, right? Again, this is custom field. It's excited and look forward to see you. So please confirm the booking. Tell them that user first name is normally super, super busy, but in tomorrow, he will be around your area and he definitely stop by and say hi if you confirm the booking now. So I'm just adding them like a couple of like real estate related trick in terms of getting people to book appointment more. So obviously like you could just change it to whatever you want. So like getting, like knowing that they will get a bonus after they book, knowing that the real estate agent will be around the area, knowing that like my real estate agent, super excited to see you, is like really gonna helpful when it comes to pushing them to book, right? This is when people ignore you. So basically how the follow-up bot work is, you can see here all of this line going to it, is when someone not respond, it will push them to the follow-up bot. So this is when people not respond, right? And the next bot, we only have 3 bots here. The next bot is the appointment booking bot. All right, first of all, at the line here, the appointment booking bot have the custom value, the appointment booking link, okay? And we're gonna like configure all of this with custom value at the end of this video. So the, again, objective here is different. The objective here that you are have a single question to ask at reply. I think it's pretty much the same, but like the objective of this one is like to book an appointment. So appointment booking guideline, casually mentioned, as part of your dialogue, this is what I add as well. Tell them, you will let them know that you booked, so you can confirm it. Mention there will be a bonus. Again, similar thing that you just saw, and I'll be in around the area. So all of that is preloaded. I don't think there's much you have to change because this is very similar. I would just like have a good look at all of the prompt, make sure that it's actually targeting your industry, either for you or for your client, and then it's pretty much ready to go. Now, it's also say something, you know, like this is the original prompt, right? Use your VT size saying like lot or haha when necessary. It's also tell them what not to say or what to say. For example, here you say, instead of saying, I understand, I see what you mean, rest, you know, instead of saying, I apologize for the confusion, saying, sorry, I get mixed up. So it's really just, the prompt is really good. Like it's just saying, you know, instead of I didn't understand, saying, wait, what did you say? Instead of saying, I apologize for confusion, sorry if that didn't make sense. What I do is I'll try to keep the original prompt as much as possible and try to add your own flair into it. So yeah, so the next thing to actually configure it, right? And this is where you actually come to setting, right? And go to custom value, custom setting, custom value, right? So we made this super easy for you guys. You want to head over to folder and you can see conversation AI folder, right? And this is all the link that you have to fill out. So for like trigger message for offline marketing, we wrote this for you, right? We wrote it for you. So you don't even have to do anything at this stage. You just have to like launch that workflow. For database reactivation one, we actually done all of the thing for you because that's the only different thing, right? The database reactivation one is like, you know, we're in the area tomorrow, please reply yes. This one is like, we can sell your house over 50K to 100K. It's similar to reactivation lesson, but in this one, we're using conversation AI with our database reactivation, right? Next thing you have to do is just go in here and fill the company information, company name, name of the assistant, qualify question one, qualify question two. So this is probably the most important one. If you want the AI to actually know a lot about your business, you probably like go into detail and write like a whole paragraph about this. So then the AI know what your value is, what you do and all that stuff, right? Otherwise, there's not much you have to do here. Let's just show 100, show more. And website link, the booking link here is very important, guys. Like just go set up the calendar and put the booking link in here. Company name, name of assistant, question one and two, you know, That's all you have to do. You just have to really add this information in, and then the whole workflow will just work. That's it. The one more important thing is that the appointment thing, like the appointment workflow, you got to make sure that when somebody book an appointment, you just need to like remove them from the bot workflow, right? You just need to make sure that whatever workflow you have active, or I would even go to remove from all workflow, because you don't want to have the bot keep messaging them after they book appointment, right? That's why the appointment workflow is there. But the most important thing, just make sure that you remove them from the bot, because this bot, it can literally put people on a loop, right? It will like continue to follow up with people until they take action, which is number one. The next thing I would recommend that you guys do is actually test it before you actually like, you know, go to test workflow here and add your name on it. Obviously, this account has no contacts and it doesn't have SMS to send. So I can't really like show you guys right now. But I would want to test the workflow and select your name on it and like get to have conversation with your bot first before you actually launch it live for your client. Now, if anything broken, anything doesn't work, like the bot stopped responding, you just have to come to enrollment history here and check the log and check like view more detail and all that stuff, right? Again, the tech setup will help you in real time, because there's actually a million possible scenario where it doesn't work, or you know, if it does work. So like we would do to help you resolve any of this. But this is it. This is conversation AI. Hopefully it makes sense. Hopefully I've done a good job explaining to you guys how to set it up and explain the workflow. It worked really well from the thing we're testing it, and we're launching it for our client pretty soon. And this is very new to the high level community, and it's very new to everyone else. But otherwise, I'll see you on the next one.